So, good afternoon, everyone. I am Asma Mahana, and I am currently pursuing BSc Honours from Amity University in Forensic Science. My today's topic of e-poster is Law Merger. In this Silicon Age, we are finding many crimes, many digital crimes that are rising. So, on the basis of that, I have created my poster that we should know about, because many of us does not know about the laws that actually helps us to find the criminal for the sexual harassment that we face online. So yes, cyber crime, that is, it is not a defined term in any rule book, but the word cyber, it is actually related to anything for computers, IT, internet, and virtual reality. And all the offenses related to computer, IT, internet, virtual reality are the crimes that comes under cyber crime. Now, there are some parallel provisions in the IPC, that is the Indian Penal Code, and the IT Act, which overlaps each other and punishes the criminal on the basis of that. First, identity theft and cheating by personation. So, Section 66C of IT Act deals with anyone who fraudulently or dishonestly makes use of any electronic sign, password, or any other unique identification feature of any other person. And this overlaps with the Section 419 of IPC, which prescribes for cheating for personation. Also, there are some other sections such as Section 463, 465, and 468 of IPC, which deals with forgery and forgery for the purpose of cheating, which may also be included in the case of identity theft. The next, the only difference between the punishment prescribed under the IPC and the IT Act are that there is no maximum cap on the fine prescribed under the IPC Act. And the most important is the relation to offense of identity theft is that the IT Act sections requires the offense to be committed on the computer resource. The second section which overlaps is Section 67 and 67B, that is of obscenity, that prescribes that punishment for publishing or transmitting in electronic form any obscene material or material containing any sexually explicit act or material depicting children in sexually explicit act. This provision of Section 292 and 294 of IPC would overlap with the IT Act of Section 67 and 67B. Further, there are some sections which are included in the IT Act, but this certainly does not overlap the IPC. So the punishment for them may be less, or the criminal would may not be handled the way if when the IPC and IT works together. So there is Section 65 of IT Act, which prescribes punishment for tampering with computer source documents and provides that any person who knowingly conceals, destroys, or alters any computer source code, computer program or system, or computer network when the source code is required to be kept by law for the time being shall be punishable with imprisonment for up to 3 years or a fine up to 3 lakhs. Section 409 overlaps to certain extent with Section 65 of IT Act. The next section is Section 66E, that is punishment for violation of privacy, that provides any person who intentionally captures, publishes, transmits any image of a private area of any person without his or her consent under circumstances violates the privacy of that person and shall be punished accordingly. There is no provision in the IPC that mirrors Section 66E, whereas Section 292 and 509 of IPC can cover this offense partially. Now, these were some of the laws that I have explained in IT Act and IPC. What was my main objective for explaining these was that I myself have been cheated by personation and by identity theft, during which there were my photo was morphed and was published, not published, but shared on Instagram handle, which at that time I did not know that I had certain provisions in the law using which I can file a complaint for the criminal. And thus, just to make a just to make everyone know about this and to create awareness that there are laws which can protect us, and sexual harassment can be reduced by by a huge percentage is my main motive to represent this poster. Thank you.